last many years, and I have experience to travel all around the world for research material for my book called The Search, which is written on information and comparative study of all religions. As my research was based on interfaith and harmony, so I visited all the religious places from mosque to gurdwaras, church, synagogue, and mandirs. During this experience, I learned that each and every religion highlights the love and harmony with the mankind. Our religious belongings attach our bondings of humanity. We share our mutual feelings despite of some differences. We all cry when we are sad. We all joy when we are happy. We share same birth process to come into this world. We all believe on the harsh reality of death. Joys and sorrows are attached with our internal beliefs, and those beliefs directs us to realize and feel the pain of humans. Of course, humanity is the basic ingredient of a religion. A peaceful society can only achieve its goal by accepting the facts that humanity is bigger than our ego or any negative perception or even differences or disputes. We all dream for a land to be accepted, to be loved with care, dignity, value, and respect. It is said that knowledge is the key to clear the basic concepts. Each and every country has some basic fundamental rights for its citizens. The term fundamental rights cover the respect for minorities and the value to interfaith. From European law to international law, we can find such provisions all around the globe. We know that media can contribute a great role to educate the society on such subjects. Let's encourage the theme to respect the bonding I mentioned earlier, the bonding of humanity. It is said that education is must for environmental protection. By spreading the knowledge of love, peace, tolerance, and acceptability, we can achieve this goal to value humanity regardless of any differences. Free speech would need no restrictions. Free speech would need no restrictions. But when we understand the bonding of humanity, I would like to repeat this sentence again, that for freedom or for democracy, free speech would need no restrictions. But when we understand the bonding of humanity, let's be united to achieve the aims for our mutual interest. Let's concentrate to care one another by putting constructive ideas for the development and progress, and finally for global peace. Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to conclude my speech by quoting Nelson Mandela's statement that no one is born hating another person because of the color of his skin or his religion or his background. People may learn to hate, and if they can learn to hate, they can be taught to love. But love comes more naturally to the human heart than its opposite. Ladies and gentlemen, this is my first event to join Ms. Shoshana and you guys here. But I'm working for interreligions and intercultural harmony. This is my basic objective of our NGO, of our organization, and I'm the part of OIC, Organization of Islamic Cooperation. That is the second largest organization in the world after UN. And I'm the part of that, and I'm the panelist speaker for that.